Hands up for Jesus in the atmosphere. For Jesus in the atmosphere. Hands up for Jesus in the atmosphere. For Jesus in the atmosphere.
Oh, haters, God gave me faith.
If you really need to know,
you can't touch me, not now, not later. Oh, haters, God gave me faith.
If you really need to see,
you can't touch me, not now, not later.
1,000 shall fall at thy side.
Watch them drop.
And 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. People want to say this is pride. But they don't understand how the Holy Spirit guides us that are godly while they're still living that lie.
Why?
We just keep praying, worshiping, praising, so he keeps us arising. Not possible to dubs such a bright guy. Of he who walks in the light that Jesus is providing. They only keep on hating because they're miserable.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. And this is just like a quick update video along with mentioning or talking about the death of Dmx, which happened, occurred yesterday. But the Spirit of the Lord didn't want me to, I didn't move to speak on it really quickly because that one hit me a little different. And I'll get into that in a moment. But this is just a quick update. First of all, the Lord is doing great things. No, Apostle Makhario is not sick. Nothing like that happened. I told you guys, God always has me covered. Soon to be going out of town sometime in May here and in April, the end of April. So God is doing great things, but it's been a lot of ministry. And like I tell you guys, sometimes when I take a break or I'm away from YouTube, it's a lot of ministry going on. And that's what it's been the past 2 or 3 weeks, especially. I mean, even more than that, and I still tried to give you guys videos in between, but it's been a lot of ministry. And so I want to give you guys a partial testimony of one of the times that God showed up in the many times that I've been out doing things for the Lord the past few weeks. But I was at a particular church and the Spirit of the Lord told me to go, and the young prophets were there with me, and the prophets that I'm training up, the Lord has me training up. And so God began to have me prophesy to a lady in the church who was a mother of about 6 or 7 children. And as I began to prophesy to her, one of her daughters was actually sitting there. And as our daughter was sitting there, the Spirit of the Lord began to have me prophesy to her daughter in the midst of prophesying to her. And so after all of that occurred and the Spirit of the Lord moved and people just kept coming for prayer, she ended up texting me later that week. And I just want to read to you part of what she texted, just to let you know how God will show up or move in your life as long as you're lining yourself up with the things of God and with Jesus Christ and what the Holy Spirit tells you to do. And so this is, when I say a lot of ministry, this is just one of the testimonies of many that I have in the past few weeks that you all have not seen me on YouTube or teaching you guys on YouTube. And she said, I was just thanking you. She texted me and said, I was just thanking you and your crew, the young men that I'm training, for surrounding, and her daughter's name is what she put there, with the love of Christ. She's never had any male figures in her life except boys, and you know what that means. She gained strength and confidence I've never seen in her before that night, and even came to me with a situation, or with a rape situation, she had experienced or she had held inside due to guilt. So I want you all to understand what God is doing and how God will allow people to develop who they are in him through you obeying the voice of God, the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. So her mom was texting us to say, hey, and the young lady is probably 19 or 20, I believe, years old. And she had mentioned, the funny thing is, when I was prophesying to her that night, she had mentioned that part of her thing was she had this resentment, or like her attitude toward her mother was not the best. And that night, as I was prophesying to her mother and to her, she just began to, share, like, I guess it was the conviction of the Holy Ghost. I don't want to say, I guess, I know it was, but this has happened the past couple weeks that the prophets have been with me and they've seen me prophesying to people, or things have been going on where people just feel compelled to confess their sins. That's what I meant to say. Compelled to confess their sins. And so, as the truth of God is getting into them, or the word of God is getting there with them, they begin to share what they're going through, things that they're going through, because they realize that God has opened a way for them to get set free. And so after that, her mother texts me the text that I just read to you all concerning that. So it's just been a lot of ministry going on while you all have not seen me here teaching you on YouTube. And it's just ministry in different aspects. That wasn't the only night. There was another past Saturday. Saturday gone, okay? I'm actually doing this video on Saturday. This is April the 10th. Saturday, April the 10th. So the past Saturday, another situation like that occurred where the Spirit of the Lord was in a place. I was invited somewhere by Prophet Songman, who you all have seen. And as we're there and he was teaching, he asked me to come, and I came, and then the Spirit of the Lord just began to move. And so people felt compelled to confess some of their sins and what they had been going through. And that's the Holy Spirit, just conviction of the Holy Ghost, which is good, because that means the Word of God is getting to them where it should be in their heart and developing them and causing things to occur. And the young lady, as we were wrapping up and we were ending, Prophet Sungman asked me to pray. And before I prayed, I said, anyone needs prayer for anything particular? And people started to share. And the young lady just began to share what she was going through, and that she was going to see a doctor for a certain thing and all of these things. But what we were teaching was convicting them as we were teaching, because they were compelled to confess some of their sins and what they had been experiencing. And even some testimonies that actually lined up with what God had Prophet Sungman teach and what I was helping expound on. And so as I began to pray, I prayed for the young lady last, but she just began to weep. And the Spirit of the Lord just began to do things in and through her and for her. And when the Spirit of God is someplace, when Jesus Christ is someplace, as the Bible says in Matthew chapter 18, verse 20, where Jesus said, where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst. As the Spirit of God began to move, she just began to weep. And after we got finished praying, she was still weeping. And she just said, thank you. She just kept saying thank you, because the Spirit of God was doing something in her life at that point in time, at that moment. And she ended up asking, do we do this every Saturday? And Prophet Sungman had to tell her, no, not every Saturday, but I teach them every Sunday at 2 p.m. at this point in time, because I don't yet have a church building, but God is working that out as well. There are other things that God has been lining up that I thought about for a moment and then never thought about again, because I knew it has to come with getting the church building, but I wasn't meditating on it. But God was already lining things up where things are falling into place quickly. The only reason I'm waiting a little bit is because I'm going out of the town and then out of the country in May. So I didn't want to put that there without being here to make sure everything is squared away. But God has been moving. So that's the gist of what I'm trying to tell you. So when you see me take time away, it's not that I'm not doing ministry. It's not that I'm sick or anything of that nature. Nothing like that has occurred. I'm actually on the east side now to go visit my dad for a little bit. But God is just moving in miraculous ways. And there are other things that have occurred throughout these past couple weeks that you've not seen me on YouTube, where God is just manifesting his glory. At the end of the day, that's what it's about. Winning souls, bringing people to Jesus Christ, letting people get developed in who they are, learning who they are, gaining their confidence in who they are, and not necessarily people's opinions and all the other foolishness that social media has. People out here trying to do, become viral, get famous, all that other nonsense. It's about you knowing who God created you to be through Jesus Christ and by the Holy Spirit, and understanding who you are. That way you're not carried about with every new fad and trend that comes along that makes you feel validated, when inside you're not necessarily validated in who you are, but you're still struggling with who you are and what you're going through. So when the mother texted me that she had gained confidence that she had never seen in her daughter before, because true men of God came and manifested the glory of God in her life, that is important. That's a testimony of who Jesus Christ is, of who God the Father is. She had gained that confidence so much that she was able to tell her mother about a situation where she had been raped that she had never shared with her mother before, and she held it inside all those years. So ministry is important. Doing the things of God are important. Now, just to touch on the DMX, the death of DMX, that one hit me a little different, because I had met DMX once before. You all know that I used to live on Miami Beach, and living on Miami Beach, I got to meet celebrities. And I'm not name dropping here for recognition of any kind or like any type of whatever. That one hit me different because at the time I met DMX, I was just leaving, or we had just moved out of Betty Wright's house, who passed away, I believe it was last year, might have been 2019. We had just left Betty Wright's house, who was also another very well-known musician. And God had opened that door through my mother. My mother and Betty Wright knew each other very well. And in the midst of that, as you all know, I had created my first CD, my first album, which was called Perspicacity, right? And so we're living on Miami Beach, and I was outside the Colony Hotel, I believe it was the Colony, right on Ocean Drive. And I knew people at the Colony, so that morning I got up and I was there. I knew the bartender and some other people, and I would just hang out there because it was right in the front of the hotel. There was like a little bar. I don't know if it's still there when I go back down there the end of this month. We're going to Florida. When I go back down there the end of this month, I'll be able to show them. But on Ocean Drive, God sent me there, and at first I went inside, and the Spirit of the Lord said, get up and go outside of the hotel and post up your CDs. So what I used to do is, as people are walking by, I would have two CDs cornered to each other so they could see the front cover. So DMX saw the front cover of this CD, and as he was walking by, he stopped and he was like, yo, is that you? And I said, yeah, and we began to talk. The funny thing is, I did not know that it was DMX. Like, it didn't hit me that it was DMX, right? Whatever happens, I treat everybody the same. That's just how I am. I've met a ton of millionaires, some billionaires, been in rooms with them, sat down with them, hung out with them, talked. I can conduct myself well, thanks be to God, the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, and my mother, who trained me a certain way. But God gave me wisdom. So as he's looking at the CD, he's looking at the front and the back of the CD. This brought back memories. I actually had to pull it out, find the CD. So as he's looking at the CD, and yes, it was shrink wrapped and all of that stuff. But one of the young ladies that was in there from another country, she was from Hungary. And she called me over real quick as he's looking at the CD. I said, excuse me one moment. And she's like, that's DMX. And I was like, what? And she said, that's DMX. I was like, oh, okay. I didn't know, you know, but he ended up buying a CD. And we talked for a quick moment. We dapped, we embraced each other, and he went on about his business. Now, at this time when I met him, he was not high on drugs. He was not drunk or nothing like that. Like I said, it was like 11 o'clock, maybe 12 in the afternoon on Miami Beach, on South Beach. And so when I met him, it was just like God, because I was God was already transitioning my life to preaching, to teaching the gospel. And the interesting thing is, I was not yet operating in the level that I operate now, you know, or that I operate in a few months after, where I was casting out devils. I was already prophesying, but casting out devils came a little bit later. And so I got to meet DMX. So when I found out yesterday that he died at 50, and I was hoping that the Lord would allow me to meet him again, so this time when I sat down and I talked with him, it would be a different conversation because of the anointing of God that's in my life. So that one hit me a little different yesterday. As the young people say, it hits different. It hit me a little different yesterday. And I did shed a few tears, just like I shed some tears when Betty Wright died, because I personally knew Betty Wright. I got to live with her for a period of time. And even then, with Betty Wright, I met Brooke Hogan, because she came. There was a thing that Betty Wright would do on Tuesdays. It was called a group of young people called The Most. And we would create music and write verses, write lyrics to the music. And so there are other celebrities that I got to meet. Same CD, I got to meet Pharrell. I got to meet Cat Williams, brought some CDs from me. And I think I shared some of this with you all before, many years ago. Now, keep in mind, this is back in 2004, 5, 6-ish, somewhere in that period, when this album was released and when I put out this album, the first album that I produced and put out. So it hit me different when I found out that DMX died, because I was praying to God that I would be able to see him again and sit down and actually minister to him, because the anointing in my life, I deal in deliverance. I cast out devils. So that's not, you know, So when a person says they have an addiction to drugs or alcohol or whatever, that doesn't affect me because I know the Spirit of God and the power of God that I walk in. So that would hit me different. I shed a few tears and I didn't want to just get up there and just say stuff. But I wanted God to talk to me. So in the midst of telling you all about this, I have to touch on this music thing again, because what happens is people, because I do music, I play the drums and different things, as you all know, it's different for me because I've seen the spiritual aspect of music. And so when they mentioned they were doing a prayer vigil and people started playing his music, and all these things, you can't have the spirit of confusion there. So if you're going to pray for him, you can't turn on the music he used to make, because the music he used to make, unfortunately, glorified more of drugs, robbing, killing, stealing, things of that nature. So if you want somebody to recover, and this is what God was talking to me about yesterday and even earlier today before I came out here, got in my car and began to, the Lord was talking, you can't have the spirit of confusion there. So you can't play secular music and then pray to God asking God to heal somebody. Even though he was a secular artist, yes, and that's the type of music he did, that's not going to help change his situation. So God began to deal with me, and this is part of what Prophet Sungmin had taught. After I taught them, he began to teach some people last Saturday, and then also this past Thursday he asked me to go somewhere with him. And so we went, and this is one of the things that we touched on, no secular music. And I'm just going to take you all here really quickly to the verses of 1 Samuel 16, chapter 16, verse 23. I'm just going to read verse 23. It says, "And it came to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, King Saul at the time, that David took an harp and played with his hands, and Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him." So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, what that means is that even if it's just jazz music or just music, melodies, whatever, that demon spirits can possess people just through music. Just as it says here that King David, or David at the time, played with his hands and he played the harp, and the demonic spirit departed from Saul because King David was anointed and all he did was play. The Bible doesn't say that he sang any words or anything. He just played the music. So you have to understand that demonic spirits can ride in beats, on beats. They are attached to music. Who you're playing the music for is who you're worshiping. Who you're creating the music for is who you're worshiping. When you're raising your hands or clapping to a song or whatever it may be, or shouting, is who you're worshiping. So if you're doing it for God, you're worshiping God. If you're doing it for the devil, you're worshiping the devil. There is no in-between when it comes to music. So I have to touch on this again, because once again, that hit me differently, finding out that DMX died. And when they said a prayer vigil, I'm sure there were people out there playing the music that he created, but the music that he created was not necessarily created for God. Unfortunately, the person that produced the beats were not doing it for God, unfortunately. So if you're asking God to heal somebody, you can't have confusion. You can't pray out of one side of your mouth and then play the music that glorifies Satan out the other side of your mouth. It's unfortunate, but it's the truth. If you claim to be a Christian artist and you're supposedly playing music for God the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, you cannot mix secular music in your quote-unquote gospel music. It does not work that way. God does not honor that. Satan will promote you, absolutely, because you're continuing the deception and the lies of the enemy. But God the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit are not going to promote you or bless you. You're going to be tormented. And that ties into what I just read to you in 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 23, that if the music is under another spirit and it's not glorifying God, those same demons get to torment you, just like the same demons that were possessing Saul, King Saul at the time, had to depart because David was anointed and doing it toward God. So the demons had to leave, and that all he did was play the music. Didn't even tie in the words. Now, there are other scriptures that I could take you to, and I'll just take you to another verse really quickly. In regards to if there are words attached to the music, it's even worse, to be honest, because people don't realize what they're pumping into their spirit and into their soul, into their heart and into their mind, and what they're meditating on. So Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29, just really quickly. It says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. So if you're asking God to heal somebody and somebody's dealing with addiction or disease or whatever, they cannot get healed if the music that you're playing, one, was not created to worship God, two, has lyrics on the music that give praise to anger and murder and robbing and stealing and calling women B's and H's or whatever. That type of music, you can't pump that into somebody's spirit and expect them to get better, because it's the opposite of what Jesus Christ is, or who Jesus Christ is. It's the opposite of God the Father. It's the opposite of the Holy Spirit, because the scripture says, Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus, or the scripture talks about, and Jesus did say in John 6:63, it is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirits and they are life. So once again, if it's made to worship God and to glorify God, then absolutely the spirit of God can come in, the anointing of God, the presence of God can come in and heal someone through music, just through music. It doesn't have to be anything else attached to it. If there are words to the music worshiping God, that's even better. Spirit of the Lord just reminded me, there's one other place that God wants me to take you to help you understand that if it's just the word of God or just the words, God can heal someone and they can get up off their sick bed or their deathbed. And that is in Ezekiel, because I want you to get this. I really want you all to get this. So when I say that, I've met people, celebrities, and I've had conversations with them. So that hit me different. Even though I got to meet him once, it hit me different, because I was hoping that God would allow me to witness and minister and sit down and talk to him again. There are other celebrities that God has revealed to me that I shall meet. The conversation shall be completely different though now, because I'm saved. I understand the anointing. I walk in the anointing. I've seen people get healed from me laying hands or praying for people. I've seen people, and I'm talking about miracles, not just little stuff, miracles. So it hit me different yesterday, because I was praying to God. I was hoping that I would have had a chance to sit down and talk to him and meet him again and show him in the scripture different things concerning music and what we put out there for other people. So you have to understand, if music will put you in a mode of anger or rage or wanting to murder, or you got to listen to a certain type of music before you have the courage to do something, then it works the opposite way as well. God created it to give life. He created it for your edification. But we could take our gifts and we could distort it and twist it and use it for Satan. So if music will put you in a mode to do certain things, to drink or to smoke or to do drugs or whatever, because the music does, I have people that will testify to you that they were listening to a certain song and they did what the song said, doing certain types of drugs. And that next thing they know, they were in a bad situation. And I'm talking about a real bad situation where they wrecked cars, ended up in prison, in jail, spoke the wrong words from certain music and had to leave concerts, which is one of the testimonies of the young men from last Saturday and this past Thursday that he shared, that he knew the lyrics to a certain song. And when he said the lyrics to this song, how the spiritual attack happened so fast that he had to leave the concert, okay? He had to leave the concert, a rock and roll concert at that. So lyrics and words and music play a factor in how your life shall be, whether you're going to be bound by the devil, whether you will have sin, sickness, and disease, or whether you will be set free by God, the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, and you can live a life of health and prosperity and be blessed in your physical body, along with your mental state and your heart, and everything else that comes along with your family, all of those things that come along with. Music plays a factor. Whether or not you want to believe it or accept it, I'm showing you in the Word of God. Lyrics play a factor. Words play a factor. Whether or not you want to believe it or accept it, I'm showing it to you in the Word of God. So yes, people can be delivered. If someone would have played DMX, my second album, When I Get Quiet, The Lion and the Lamb, he would have got up off that sick bed. My music, I know by the Spirit of God, can raise people from the dead. I know it. And I'm bold enough to say it because I know what's in the music. I know the Spirit of God that's there. Before I put it out to you guys, I listen to it. And if I feel the Holy Spirit, I feel the Holy Ghost in the music, I know that it's worth God is saying, go ahead and put that out there. I don't just put together words. I'm very particular with, that's why in my music, you'll find scripture. You'll find the Word of God in the music. Even if I don't give you book, chapter, and verse, if you know the Bible, you'll know that the Word of God is in there. And sometimes I do quote the book, chapter, and verse and give you book, chapter, and verse in the music that I create so you know. And it fits so well because the Spirit of God is in me and it lines up. But the words are just as important. That's why I don't believe in just putting things out there. If I wanted to, I could have continued to produce music. I sat down for music and gave everything to God. And so you guys got The Lion and the Lamb, When I Get Quiet, The Lion and the Lamb in 2019, but that was like 10 or 11 years, maybe 12 years after I put out this album, because I wanted to make sure that what I put out for people is going to glorify God. Like other artists, they just sit down and they start talking and creating music and whatever. And yes, I could do it. There are tons of words that are at my disposal. There's a ton of truth that I can give you that's at my disposal. But I decided to, hey God, you take control of everything. So when I changed my life over, I stopped going into the clubs. I stopped doing all of that. Because God, I wanted God to have control, Jesus Christ to have control, the Holy Spirit to have control of everything that I did. That way everything brings people back to God the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. It's not about me. So really quickly, just to give you all, another thing concerning words that you understand. The Word of God is quick and powerful, Hebrews 4:12, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, of the joints and the marrow, is a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. Okay, so getting into it, Ezekiel 1, I'll just start at 1, verse 28, and then we'll go to 2, verse 2. I want you all to get this. So Ezekiel 1:28, it says, and as the appearance, actually go to verse 27, it says, and I saw as the color of amber, as the appearance of fire round about within it, from the appearance of his loins, this is talking about Jesus actually, from his loins even upward, and from the appearance of his loins even downward, I saw as it were the appearance of fire, and it was brightness round about. Verse 28 is important. It says, and as the appearance of the bow that is in the cloud in the day of rain, so a rainbow, so was the appearance of his brightness round about. This was the appearance of the likeness of the glory of the Lord. And when I saw it, I fell upon my face, and I heard a voice of one that spake. So once again, it's talking about Jesus. When Ezekiel saw, not even Jesus in his full image, but just what was the appearance of Jesus Christ, it says he fell upon his face. And if you all know, I've taught on this before, when God shows up, you fell on your face as a dead person, for real, for real. And that's what he says here. And I'm going to give you what it ties into in regards to words. It says in 2 of Ezekiel, 2, this is now Jesus speaking to him. It says, actually, 2, starting at 1. It says, and he said unto me, son of man, stand upon thy feet, and I will speak unto thee. Now, 2 is important. It says in 2 of Ezekiel 2, and the Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me, and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me. So when God speaks, when Jesus Christ speaks, when the Holy Spirit moves upon the words, it says in 2, and the Spirit, this is the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, entered into me when he spake unto me, and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me. Without God the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, there is no life. So when Jesus said in 6:63, it is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. That's exactly what God meant, and it's lined up all throughout the Bible. But if you are listening to words that are not of God, there is going to be no life given unto you. So this is another reason why we do not listen to secular music, why we do not play secular music in our spirits, in our system, because it's against God, and you're not going to get life from it. You're going to get the opposite. You're going to get death. You're going to get hatred, anger, bitterness, unforgiveness, wrath, strife, sedition, murder. You're going to get lust, perversion. That's what you're going to get from secular music. But what you're going to get from godly music is the complete opposite. You're going to get life. So this was just one, a quick update on the ministry. The links are in the description below if you want to tithe or give to the ministry, whether you do it through Zelle or whether you do it through sending a check to the P.O. box, to the glory of the Lord, to help build the church and the house of God. And actually, going back into the update on what's going on with the ministry and different things, God has also been having people prophesy that I've never met, to people that know me, to get the word to me. One of the other prophets, Prophet Todd, gentlemen, prophesied to him concerning the ministry and what God was doing for me and for the ministry that God has me building and creating. And it was very accurate, but it's things that I had already told them. And so God was just using the other prophet that this Prophet Todd knew to confirm what God was doing. So ladies and gentlemen, God is doing great things, and I wish I could give it all to you all right now, but you talk about revival. Trust and believe when I tell you it's coming, and it shall be at the church that God gave me. So, and this will be revival like America's not seen in a long, long time. Because the level of understanding, knowledge, understanding, wisdom, revelation is completely different. And the dying to self is completely different. So when you ask God for a revival, it's coming. True revival, not the phony ones that you guys have seen that you thought was a revival that wasn't actually a revival. I'm talking about revival where the place is packed out to the point where people can't sit down because they're in there to get the word of God and to see the manifestation of his glory. True revival. But the death of DMX did hit me different because I got to meet him along with other celebrities. When I finally get to see, hopefully in the name of Jesus, Pharrell again, our conversation will be different, because I didn't know previous that Pharrell grew up in the church until a few years back, where the Lord had him, and then he mentioned it again in another interview that I watched or that I got to see, where he grew up in the church. There are a lot of people that I tell you all that grew up in the church that turned away from God for a dollar. But when they sit down and meet someone that's not starstruck, because I don't get starstruck, that how much money you have doesn't move me. How much you've been on TV doesn't move me. I treat everybody the same. And some of the other people that God is going to hopefully have me sit down with again, some of the people that God revealed to me spiritually that I will sit down with again, conversation is going to be different. And yes, they're secular people, but they have a soul. So yes, I shed tears for DMX because he has a soul. And I did get to meet him. And I was hoping that I would get to meet him again and sit down and have a different conversation this time around, even about the music, because we both did music. But God does everything for a reason. So, but I love you all. I will see you all again soon. May God bless. Ministry is still going on. We are out.
Hands up for Jesus in the atmosphere. For Jesus in the atmosphere. Hands up for Jesus in the atmosphere. For Jesus in the atmosphere.
The haters, God gave me faith.
If you really need to know,
that you can't touch me, not now, not later. The haters, God gave me faith.
If you really need to see,
you can't touch me, not now, not later.
1,000 shall fall at thy side.
Watch them drop.
And 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come neither.
Nope.
People want to say this is pride.
Uh-huh.
But they don't understand how the Holy Spirit guides us that are godly while they're still living that lie.
Why?
We just keep praying, worshiping, praising, so he keeps us arising. Not possible to dub such a bright guy. Of he who walks in the light that Jesus is providing.
Yeah.
They only keep on hating because they're miserable.